What's up, people of the internet? I'm the Big Boat here with yet another video. In this video we'll be testing the Intel Celeron N2840, which is a power efficient processor based on the Bay Trail architecture. It's a dual core CPU with no hyper threading of course, and it has a burst frequency of up to 2.58 GHz. The Celeron N2840 has the Intel HD graphics Bay Trail as the integrated graphics. This iGPU is actually based on the same architecture as the Intel HD 4000, except that it's significantly nerfed with its whopping 4 unified shaders. We also have 4 GB of RAM in single channel mode, as well as a 500 GB hard drive for the operating system, and also on which the game that we'll be playing today is installed. As for operating system, we're using normal Windows 10 as mom also uses the PC. You can find a full description of the specs in the video description down below. The game that we'll be benchmarking today is CSGO. Just like the previous Battlefield 3 video, this is also a revision video as I've already tested CSGO before. The reason why I'm revisiting it might make you laugh. So, while I was making the old video, I accidentally left the enabled developer console option on while trying to get into a normal multiplayer match. So guess what? As a result of this, while I wasn't banned from the game entirely, I couldn't access a match against other humans. So I thought, no problem, I'll just play a bot match for the benchmark. But since bots are far more CPU intensive than human players, the game ran at 5 FPS. And I made the old video without realizing that. Oh well. But after recently reinstalling Steam and the game on the laptop, I can finally join proper matches now. And we are going to see if the N2840 does a better job than last time, in a team versus team deathmatch to be exact. So let's get straight to the point now. Also, remember the Memory Reduct app? Well, I'll be using it once again, as CSGO consumes quite a lot of RAM nowadays.
Thank you.
Well, it certainly runs much better than in a bot match. Now, in the comment section of the previous CSGO video, you guys suggested some stuff, but one interesting suggestion in particular is this interesting command, which does something really exciting to the game's okay graphics. I'll show you.